Good afternoon. My name is Sabina Washira from Kenya Medical Research Institute and in the Center for Traditional Medicine and Drug Research. The title of my presentation is Postdoctoral Training Experience, the Journey, and Everything in Between. When I was told to give a talk, I was given a blank check, and I thought it would be good to talk on that. And the journey started with the application. And I've really seen most of those people. We were together during the interview. Those we were together during the initial times of life. And I'm talking about the journey of the 2-year postdoctoral research fellowship, and it has a grant number. And the title of the project was Exploiting Mosquito Phytosynthetics for Malaria Control. One of the things that we want to do, and we were supposed to do, and it was compulsory, is to attend a research methodology course. And this was before we even started on we embarked on our research project. And as for the award, when you accepted the award, you accepted to attend the course anyway. And I think it was a really good time to have the research team together, the first life together, all of us. And it was exciting 3 weeks away in Nimri. And we worked together for the journey of the 3 weeks. And I just decided to just highlight on some of the things that we really were learning. And I just picked on the first week timetable. I was just reminding myself of the journey as I picked things. And some of the things that you are going to see on this timetable is actually the courses that we really learned during the 3 weeks. And one of the courses that I really enjoyed, I must say this, is Personal Development Plan. Being introduced to this, because I hadn't had it before, was a very good experience to me. Because it really made me know and identify the gaps in knowledge that I required and the skills that I required for life. Not only for that specific period of time that I was in life, but also for the purpose of what I want to live for. And there were several other courses, and some of us thought they were not very important to them, but later in life, you realize you meet on some of these things along the way. I'll be talking more of that later. And the journey started. And the journey, I have said, I was working on exploiting mosquito phytosynthetics for malaria control. And what drove this is the fact that some research that had been done in Isipe had actually realized that mosquitoes feed on specific plants. And they do not only feed on specific plants to get energy for flight, but there could be more to it than just getting the food. And that is the journey that we started, of course, checking the factor behavior. And there are several factor behaviors, but our interest was on that specific sugar feeding of the mosquito using specific plants. That is the part that I was more interested on. And this is just showing on how mosquito feed on plants. And for sure, we are not so sure, but we know when the mosquito have the malaria, do they really treat themselves? Do they really have the urge of saying that, I'm now sick, I want to go for specific thing? And this could be the one to lead us to get maybe what can actually treat malaria. And that is what we dealt with, because that is what we dealt with, specific plants that really did not really give the mosquito the sugar that we thought that it could have given the mosquito the sugar. But this, we were looking for whatever that it ingest from those specific plants. And the objective of the study was to screen extracts of the most preferred mosquito feeding plants for Plasmodia activity in both the sexual and sexual stage of the parasite. Also to screen the extract for their toxicity property, and also to isolate and identify Plasmodia compounds. I'm just going to show some of the plants that we dealt with. We have Tithonia diversifolia. These are some of the common plants that we always see around us. We have Lycinus communis, Biden pilosa, that is blackjack, is all over. Parthenium estrophila, one of the colleagues of ICP, who is here, actually talked about this. And I think it's a follow-up of these several studies and recommendations that have been done before. And we have Artemisia afla and Senna botrytis. The way the study was done is using the feeding assay, and the feeding assay is what we can see there. And the extract was actually put in a fire, and the mosquito fed on this extract, and then we extracted the gut of the mosquito and actually extracted that gut and checked whether there is any trace of the plant extract from the gut of the mosquito. After doing that, we actually learned the extract through LC-MS to see and compare whether there is any trace of that extract. After that, we really did the extraction of the compound that we thought, of the plant that we actually realized is highly preferred and highly killed more mosquitoes, that is Lycina communis, and in it we isolated two compounds. These two compounds were actually tested against the mosquitoes, and it was also found that they really had the high toxicity of the mosquito. When it was also tested for Plasmodia activity against Plasmodia falciparum in vitro, it also showed to have the high LC55. About the journey of the research project, I was posing like, wow, they really achieved. And in my view that we really achieved the first bit of the first part of the objective, we did achieve. But the second part, where we had to infect the mosquitoes with the Plasmodium bugging, so that we also test whether the Plasmodium bugging, the mosquito, after mosquito getting the malaria itself, whether it will go for the extract, that is the bit that we never really achieved because of few logical issues. But the other objective we achieved, and I'm just highlighting one of the publication. The other thing that I'm going to mention, apart from the research, is the drive equipment grant. We were given the grant for the purpose of acquiring these equipment. This equipment is called incubator. It's for layering, it's Project Growth Shaper for layering mosquitoes. And why we were given this is the fact that for you to infect the mosquitoes with Plasmodium bugging, it needed specific humidity and specific temperatures. And we could not do it on the way that we are doing the others. And therefore, this was to help into that. But it came in a bit late when the project had gone beyond. And also, infecting the mosquito with Plasmodium bugging was quite a very hard, it didn't realize at that particular time. I'm now going to just talk briefly on the visit to visits that we had in Cape Lake.
with my mentor. I'm just showing the group. This is the spring group. And I must say that some of these trips that we make, they have a real life impact on our life. Now, whenever that I'm going to any lab, I'm really looking at what would lab look like. Like that one for Cambridge. We are actually innovating our labs as per now. And whenever I go to the lab, the chemistry lab that I am, we are part of the heading of the chemistry lab, I'm looking, does it have like whatever that I saw there? Because actually their labs are well made. And apart from the people, you can see the hood out there. And whenever that I'm talking to them about this is what we would want put, I'm always giving them this kind of a picture to see the lab, not the people, the lab. I just decided to show one of my mentor, Professor Spring. But this is the kind of thing, the impact that we are making when we have this kind of project or faces. The journey. Of course, the journey, as it started, of course, the journey of 1,000 miles starts with one step. And along the journey, definitely you meet so many handicaps, but you strive on. And I must mention some of the challenges, which are institution specific. Of course, I have highlighted about the initial application, working with the partner institution, stroke the mentors. First of all, when the call came in, at that particular moment, we were not supposed to have mentors per se, but we knew the institution that we were supposed to be based on. For me, it was not hard because I had my PhD in ICPE then. So I got to know many people in ICPE. But when it comes when you don't know anyone, that being a bit of challenge. And project implementation, as I say, is institution specific because it also depends with the management and the processes of that specific institution. When initially definitely life was new, the terms were different from what was known to be ICPE's levels for postdoc, and therefore there were several things that had to be put in place then for the purpose of Thrive Fellows. And this one, I'm sure it has been harmonized over the time because now we have grown the babies being now. I identified a mentor in the University of Cambridge. This was also an issue, but was made really less a pain by the presence of Pauline S. Abel. Financial management. I must say this is where you are not so sure at the beginning because you really don't know how to manage this kind of grants. As I said, institution specific, also the Thrive helped a lot because it lessened the pain of going as a fellow dealing with the cash. When the cash hasn't come, the ICPE owner give us money and then it is refunded. So there was that kind of an agreement that made it lesser pay. But project cross-up, I must say that maybe have been defined now. Maybe the closure that was there was not so good, but now the project closure needs to even have the report and all the other details in place. I was just placing a question there after publication, what next? What we do with all the knowledge that we have? Will policy belief help? How will we do it? Do we really even know how to do it? Evidence-informed policy making. This is something that maybe when we are taking in the Thrive Fellows, we should be also in the line of that teaching or training at the very early beginning so that you know how do I inform policy. How, whenever I'm doing my research, How do I now have this evidence to inform something that is tangible? Not only to influence whatever things are done, but also for the benefit of the community. The impact of, personal goals, what is it? Definitely we all had the personal goals when we started the research, when we came into the life. There are those things that drove us to apply for the life. And one of the things that drove me is to, of course, I wanted to be a great research leader in scientific research by broadening my research experience, also to enhance my research skills, also to work as a qualified researcher and achieve my goals for contributing to the global science and to find solutions to diseases. I also wanted to gain experience in writing grants, stock fellowship, and to gain experience in grant management. Also, of course, network and publish. I will say these are some of the intangible things that one of my colleagues talked here. And there are things that along the way, during the postdoc, I would say I experienced all of them. Some might have come later along the drive, postdoc, or after I have left. But the training that I had, I must say it really impacted on my life positively. And I would say I have achieved almost all that. Along my life, I just thought to have a bit of research management. And I will tell you the impact of postdoctoral training on that line of duty that I really thought I would go to research management really did. I had a taste of research management as a registrar of one of the universities between the year 2014 and 2016. And one of the main things that I was supposed to do, because it was a new university, is to develop and implement some policies related to research. And I was also supposed to coordinate fundraising for research and production. Also the monitoring and evaluation, promotion and information and incubation. Why I'm bringing in this is to see the overall parcel that is made by that. You might call it small grant of five. And this having been my first that kind of a work, I landed very much on what I have done during the Thrive postdoc. I will tell you, as a mentor, your word really matters to that specific fellow. The small thing that you tell that fellow really matters to them. I will go to the management thinking, I have to be like Professor Nelson, you know? Your behavior also really do it. Professor Toto kept on telling me, you know, you are the only person who knows what you want to tell people. People don't know what you want to tell them. It's for you to communicate to them. And imagine those few words, how they have guided my life all along through my life. The first bit I was given, duty that I was given when I went to be a registrar, is actually the minister came in, the ICT minister then, Dr. Matiani, is one of the very famous ministers in Kenya. And I was told you had to take that minister alone. And I was very grateful. And I really wondered if it was Professor Nelson, what would he have done? You know, some of these things that you really take for granted by observing, by talking, that is what I mean, it builds. And whatever that I had learned, really made me try on that to actually do what I was doing in these duties. Professional service, have it really helped? Currently, I'm spearheading the development of Kemri Research Policy based on what I had done before, and also Kemri Strategic Direction, strengthening and upskilling national and global research. I'm also part of the implementation team that is dealing with
carefully knowledge management. Having done the knowledge management somewhere else, and therefore I'm able to drive case. What do we do with the knowledge that we have? How do we synthesize it in a way that will be able to help the community and help policies? Career development. Whereas the postdoc had an impact on career development, let me say it have. Even when I had a break of 2 years, I really continued with research. I have three master students who have completed. I have ongoing three master students. I have 2 PhD students who have completed this early this year, and I have 2 ongoing PhD. The ongoing research I have, I'm passionate about the cancer research, and this I started even before the postdoc. And my research still go on that way. When I mentioned the clinical trials, and I had earlier mentioned the clinical trials during our research course, our research methodology course training. And I never thought that I will do that kind of work. But currently I'm part of the team that is actually developing and establishing the bioequivalent pilot study, so that we are able to have a bioequivalent center in East Africa. And the project is funded by East Africa Community, and I'm the one dealing with the pharmacokinetics of that work. And this is the study that have Guri University and Kemri as part of the Kenya, and also we have Tanzania and Rwanda. The other thing that I would really mention is that my future plan is actually to continually apply for research funding, collaboration and networking, mentoring, publishing. I said patenting. The reason why I said patenting is the fact that we were talking about it yesterday, and we're wondering, is it publishing or perish, patenting or perish? I don't know, but we really need to do a lot of patenting in this part of the world. The last one there is to utilize my potential in project management skills, monitoring and evaluation, knowledge management, and overall management of research. And with that, I say I acknowledge Clive, Wellcome Trust, Kenya Medical Research Institute, ICPE, University of Cambridge, and my mentors. Thank you very much.